Central Intelligence Agency. National Security Agency. Two well-known, but very classified, highly trained, and highly capable federal intelligence agencies of the United States. What sets them apart? What do they have in common? What can they do? Let's take a dive into what you need to know about the CIA and NSA. We'll start off the video with a brief introduction on both of these agencies. Let's kick it off with the CIA. The CIA is a civilian foreign intelligence service of the United States, officially tasked with gathering, processing, and analyzing national security information from around the world, primarily through human intelligence. As a principal member of the United States intelligence community, the CIA reports to the Director of National Intelligence and is primarily focused on providing intelligence for the President and Cabinet of the United States. The CIA has no law enforcement function. It is mainly focused on overseas intelligence gathering, with only limited domestic intelligence collection. It is the only agency authorized by law to carry out and oversee covert action at the direction of the President. Okay, now on to the NSA. The National Security Agency is a national-level intelligence agency of the United States Department of Defense, and operates under the authority of the Director of National Intelligence. The NSA is the largest United States intelligence organization. However, the amount of people who work in the agency is classified. It is the world leader in cryptology, which is the art and science of making and breaking codes. Alright, you just got a taste of what both of these agencies are. Let's dig a little deeper and go over their capabilities, missions, and opportunities. So you just learned that the CIA and the NSA are both intelligence agencies of the United States. Let's highlight their purposes and missions in more detail so you have a better understanding of what each of them do for the country. The CIA mainly specializes in humans, which is short for human intelligence. Like the name suggests, this is intel that is gathered by means of interpersonal contact by human sources. Picture a spy infiltrating a compound and gathering intel and reporting back to headquarters. This is an example of humans. The NSA, on the other hand, specializes in SIGINT, which is short for Signals Intelligence. SIGINT is intelligence derived from electronic signals and systems, such as communication systems, radars, and weapon systems. While the CIA may send a special agent overseas to gather intelligence, the NSA mainly has its personnel operate domestically, attempting to intercept and analyze signals from all over the world. It also defends the United States government and its interests from hacking, surveils adversaries, and much more. This means that the CIA and NSA augment each other greatly. For example, a CIA operative who is overseas may need to access intelligence gathered from an NSA satellite in order to advance or complete their mission. So, to recap, the CIA mainly deals with humans' missions, and the NSA mainly deals with SIGINT's missions. Let's move on to some of the opportunities, or more specifically, some of their special operations assets you can find yourself in. We're going to briefly talk about the CIA's Special Activity Center and Global Response Staff. And for the NSA, we're going to briefly go over their Special Collection Service and Scorpion program. For the Special Activity Center, this is the CIA's equivalent of a Tier 1 Special Operations Unit. Mostly consisting of former Tier 1 operators and former SOF members, it is responsible for covert operations and paramilitary operations. The operations it partakes in are ones in which the US government does not want to be overtly associated with. For the Global Response Staff, this is made up of former members of US Special Operations Forces, or those who have served in SWAT teams. Their mission is to guard spies, but their operations have expanded to include critical security at drone bases, defending special collection elements in the field, and transporting intelligence assets in combat zones. for the NSA Special Collections Service. It is also known as F6. It is a highly classified black budget program whose existence has never officially been acknowledged by the US government. In fact, it's actually a joint program between the NSA and CIA. It's charged with inserting eavesdropping equipment in difficult-to-reach places, such as foreign embassies, communication centers, and foreign government installations. And then for the Scorpion program, it is essentially a smaller version of the CIA's Global Response Staff. The Scorpion program is a force made up of security contractors, many of whom have a distinguished background in the US Special Operations community. Not much is known about these guys. Alright, you've been given a comparison of the capabilities and missions of the CIA and NSA. Let's briefly go over the structure of both of these agencies. After that, we will go over the training and requirements for each of them. Let's start off with the CIA's structure. Did you know General Discharge has an Instagram? We actively post memes, video updates, and whatever else we feel like. Join the team and follow us at general.discharge. Links in the description. Now back to the video. The CIA is broken into 5 different directorates. There's the Directorate of Operations, Directorate of Analysis, Directorate of Science and Technology, Directorate of Support, and the Directorate of Digital Innovation. These directorates all work in tandem to fulfill the CIA's mission. Collecting foreign intelligence that matters, producing objective all-source analysis, conducting effective covert action as directed by the president, and safeguarding the secrets that help keep the United States safe. Now that you know the generic idea of how the CIA is structured, let's go over the NSA structure. Actually, no one really knows the structure of the NSA. All we know is that as of 2013, it has about a dozen directorates, which are designated by a letter, although not all of them are publicly known. We weren't kidding when we said this agency was highly classified. Now that you have an idea of what the US government allows you to know about the structure of both of these agencies, let's move on to the training to get into them, then the requirements, and then we will wrap up the video. Let's start off with the training to get into the CIA. There's a lot of diversification as to where CIA officers receive their training from, because there's a whole slew of career fields in the CIA. But if we had to guess, you're probably most interested in where the clandestine agents receive training, which are the ones in the DO and SAC. These are the positions that exist within this area. So if you find yourself in any of those lines of work, there are 2 routes you will take. There's the Professional Trainee Program and the Clandestine Service Trainee Program. We'll briefly explain these 2 for you. The PT program is designed as an entry-level program for individuals seeking a career as a core collector in an overseas mission. Candidates for the Professional Trainee Program must possess a bachelor's degree. Substantial work experience is not a requirement, as most trainees receive experience through a number of headquarters-based assignments. These are typically applicants who are fresh out of college. It's a precursor to the CST program. The CST program is 18 months long, and is for applicants who have prior professional, military, or other non-academic experience. It is designed to train and certify individuals to successfully recruit and handle foreign sources who can provide access to vital human intelligence. A lot of this training is conducted at what is known as the Farm at Camp Peary, Virginia, and also receive training at The Point near Hertford, North Carolina. Just remember, the CIA is very mute about what it does and how they conduct their training. Don't expect to know a week-by-week breakdown of things like you can find out about a military branch boot camp. Let's move on to the training to get into the NSA. Like the CIA, the NSA doesn't have a one-track curriculum you need to complete to join the agency. There's no NSA Academy, like you'd expect. There's a whole slew of career fields in the NSA. We'll show you. On screen are all of them. There's a lot. For the cyber and intelligence career fields, the NSA and the intelligence community offer advanced training opportunities at the National Cryptologic School and National Intelligence University. Due to how many career fields there are in the NSA, the requirements to get in will greatly vary. Just know that it is virtually impossible to land a job here without a degree, especially in the intelligence and cyberspace areas. Okay. So now you know what training you'll be expected to complete if you decide to embark on either of these journeys. But do you even qualify to give it a shot? Let's see. The This section is going to be very brief, because as we just showed you in the previous section, there are several different career fields in both of these agencies. For the CIA, these are the minimum requirements, and these are the desired requirements. Pause the screen to take a longer look. For the NSA, a safe bet for you is to have a college degree in some form of intelligence, computer science, data analysis, or something cyber-related. You most likely will not land a job at the NSA without a degree. Alright, now you know the basic requirements for both the CIA and NSA. But don't go just yet. We're about to wrap up the video and leave you with some valuable resources to go check out about both of these communities, as we can't cover everything in detail in just this video. In this video, you learned that the CIA and NSA are very similar, yet quite different. Both agencies are highly secretive, operate under the shadows, and provide intelligence and security for the United States. The CIA specializes in human intelligence, and the NSA specializes in signals intelligence. Both of these agencies work in tandem to keep the US safe. With that said, if you made it this far, which one do you prefer? The CIA or the NSA? Let us know in the comments section below. As far as videos go, if you like the versus video format, we've done other videos like this. The thumbnails on screen are the versus videos we've done thus far. The playlist to these will all be in the description below. And if you're into learning more about other civilian and law enforcement entities, we've done plenty of videos on them. On screen are all the videos we've done thus far. There will be a playlist in the description for them. Well, that is the down and dirty of the Central Intelligence Agency and National Security Agency. If you learned something from this video, make sure to give us a like and subscribe to our channel. As always, thank you for watching. Do you even want to be here? A big shout out to all of our YouTube members and our patrons over at our Patreon. Thank you all so much for taking the extra step in supporting our channel. It is much appreciated. If you'd like to be featured on a General Discharge video, consider joining our membership with the link in the description or the join button to the left of the subscribe button, or go give our Patreon a look and join the team. Here's Nick Nausea.
All your friends are subscribing to General Discharge, and you don't even want to be here.